See, the design procedure of sleeve or muff coupling. So in the sleeve or muff coupling consists of three basic parts, that is muff, key and shaft. So here you know that coupling is used to connect two shafts. So this muff coupling is a simple rigid type of coupling, and here two shafts are inserted in this muff, and this muff will, is nothing but a hollow shaft. You can treat it as a hollow shaft such that two shafts are connected end to end, and those are connected by a key here. So here in this design procedure of muff coupling, we have to design these three parts, nothing but shaft, key and muff. So here, first of all, if you see the design of shaft, the design of shaft, but you know that finding out the diameter. So how will you find out the diameter of the shaft? So if you know the power transmitted by the shaft and also torque, you can find out the diameter of the shaft. So here the first step is the design of shaft. Design of shaft we are going to find out, that is capital D, let us take. So you know that power transmitted by the shaft is nothing but 2 pi n t by 60, this many watts, is it clear? So here if you know RPM also, and you can find out the diameter. How can you find out the diameter? Means, see here, from this equation we can write t is equals to 60 p by 2 pi n. So here if you know power and if you know RPM of the shaft, you can find out torque. From that we can find out the diameter. How means, let us see. See, you also know that the torque transmitted by a solid circular shaft is nothing but pi by 16 tau dq. So here tau is nothing but shear stress induced in the shaft, and here you have d. So from this, if you know power, you can substitute power and RPM here, you can find out torque, and the torque you will substitute here, and if you know the shear stress induced in the shaft, you can find out the diameter. So that is, in the first step we can find out the diameter. And here see the power must be in watts such that you will get torque in Newton meter. And if you get the torque in Newton meter, see here, while substituting here, you have to take care that, so if you require the diameter of the shaft in mm, you have to substitute this torque value in Newton mm only. But here the value of the power generally given in the problem is watts only. So here you will get the torque value in Newton meter only. And if you want to get diameter in mm, you have to convert this Newton meter into Newton mm. So that you know that if you convert meter into mm, that is 1 meter is equals to 1000 mm. And I can say that R 10 to the power of 3. So I can write here into 10 to the power of 3. So here whatever value you get here in Newton meters, that into 10 to the power of 3 you have to substitute here to get the diameter of shaft in mm. So that is the first part of the design of shaft. And if you see next step, we'll see the design of sleeve or muff. Design of sleeve or muff. So I said that this sleeve or muff is nothing but a hollow shaft. So let's we can assume that it is a hollow shaft whose inside diameter is nothing but diameter of the shaft. And outside diameter, let us take the symbol as capital D. And for this sleeve or muff coupling, we have some proportions. The outside diameter of the sleeve or muff is taken as 2D plus 13 mm. And length of the muff is taken as 3.5D, where D is the diameter of shaft in mm. And that is also treated as inside diameter of the sleeve and muff. So these are the standard proportions we will take for the muff. And from these proportions, first of all, we will get some values of the outside diameter and length of the muff. And that values we will check for the stress induced in the muff, such that if the stress induced in the muff is within the limits of the material, you can say that these proportions are right. So let us see that. So you know capital D is nothing but 2D plus 13 mm. And L is equals to 3.5D. So from that, suppose we got some values for capital D in mm and also length of the sleeve or muff in mm. So you know that I said that this sleeve or muff is treated as a hollow shaft, and you know that torque transmitted by a hollow shaft is nothing but pi by 16 tau capital D power 4 minus small d power 4 by capital D. So from this equation, we'll check the shear stress induced in the shaft.
So you know that from this one and this one you can substitute the here the values, and torque is nothing but torque is same for all those elements, that is sleeve, arm of and key and this shaft. So in the first step we have already find out the torque value you have to substitute here, and you can find out the induced shear stress in this case. And if this induced shear stress is less than the permissible value, you can say that these proportions you have taken from here are right. So next step is nothing but design of key. So here we have the key here. So the last element in this is key. Here design of key, the last element we have designing of. So this key is generally made into two parts, and one part is inserted in one part of the shaft, other part is inserted in other part of the shaft. And here, so the proportion, suppose we assume, if we assume a rectangular key, since that is nothing but the cross section of the key is a rectangle. So this is the width of the key and this is the thickness of the key. And if you assume a rectangular key, so the usual proportion of width of the key is nothing but W is equals to D by 4 mm. So where D is nothing but diameter of the shaft, you know, D is dia of shaft in mm. And thickness of key is given by the proportion D by 6 mm. So same meaning, D is diameter of the shaft. So these are the proportions of a rectangular key generally we'll assume. And length of the key, is, I say that these keys are made into two parts, and one part of the key is inserted in one side of the shaft and other part of the key is inserted in other part of the shaft. So this, you can say that total length we have assumed for the sleeve is 3.5D, such that at least in one part of the shaft we can say that L is equals to 3.5D by 2. So this is also in mm. So these are the three proportions we'll take, and we'll get some values for the width, thickness and length of the key. And here these values are checked against the shear stress and crushing stress induced in the key. So let us say, first of all, check for the shear stress, induced in the key. So see here, when we are giving the power here, you know that the power transmits like this. See, suppose if you are giving power input from this side, so that power or torque transmit like this. First of all, this is the input shaft. From this, it will go to key. From that key, it will go to the muff. And from the muff, it will transfer the other part of the key. And from that, it will transfer other shaft, and it goes out like this. So this is the direction of power flow in this coupling. So see here, so while it transmitting the power or torque, so each and every element must transmit the same amount of torque. Or you can say that each and every element is subjected to the same amount of torque, and such that each and every element should oppose or resist the same torque. So such that if you see here, so in this shear stress induced in the key also, you know, torque we have already calculated in the first step, and the torque value we'll take here, and that will be checked against the shear stress induced in the key. How? See here. So generally we know torque formula is a basic formula of torque is nothing but force into radius. So here radius means this key is approximately at a distance of D by 2 from here, from the axis of the coupling. So it is approximately placed at the D by 2 location, small d by 2. So such that here you can say here small r you can write as small d by 2. And here force, you know, force is equals to stress into area. Force is equals to stress into area. How can we say this stress into area? You know that stress definition. Stress is equals to load by area. So load or force is the same. So load or force. So here you can write force in is equals to stress into area. So that I can write here stress into area in the place of force. Is it clear? So here stress, what kind of stress we are taking here? We are checking against the shear stress. So we have to write shear stress of the key material and area. See here, So when we are transmitting the torque, so it will suppose it is rotating like this. So you just assume like this. So you just take the shaft and you have placed the key here like this. And when it is rotating, see, this will apply a tangential force in the key. So this force is responsible for the shear of this key, such that, let us see, if you see in the other view, so it will cut like this, and if you see in the top view, so like this. So this is the area which is subjected to shear, and here we can say that this is nothing but W, and this will become W, and this will become length. So this is the area which is subjected to this shear force. So we can, in the place of area, I can write W into L, and this is D by 2. See here, torque, I told that torque is same. From the first step, we can take the torque value, and here we will check for the induced shear stress in the key. So this W and L values will take from here, and we will substitute here W and L. D value we have calculated in the first step itself. Torque value we got from the first step itself. So here we will find out the shear stress induced in the key. So that shear stress induced in the key, induced shear stress in the key must be less than the tau allowable for the key material. So this is the one way of checking the key. And also you have other way, you have to check other criteria also, that is shear stress, crushing stress induced in the key. So that is, let us check that. Check the key for crushing stress. And see here, so what is crushing means, so when it is rotating like this, it will apply a force. See, this is a key, and this is, we have taken length of the key, and this is, suppose if you assume this is thickness, and if you see the side view, this is W and this is T. And here crushing means this shaft will apply, the shaft surface will apply force on this key, because this key is placed in the shaft, half of the key is placed in the shaft. So this shaft surface will apply a force on this key material, shaft surface will apply force on the key surface, so throughout its length. So this force is compressive force, which will try to crush the key. So what is the area here we have to take, means this is the area. So that is nothing but here, if you take, this is a T, so this will become T by 2, and this is the L. So if you write once again the torque equation, we have seen that torque is nothing but force into radius, the basic equation, and radius we have already seen that it is D by 2, force is equals to stress. Stress into area we have seen already. Stress means here crushing stress we have taken, so we have to take the crushing stress for key material. And area is nothing but T by 2 into L into, this is D by 2 I have written already. So this here also, so this we have already written, T is equals to D by 6. Here we will get the dimension of T, and length is equals to some 3.5 D by 2 we will get length, and diameter we have already find out. So here we have find out the crushing stress induced in the key material from this equation, and you know already this torque we have already find out. So from this we will find out the crushing stress induced in the key, and the crushing stress induced in the key will check for the allowable crushing stress for the key material. So it should be less than the allowable value, such that these dimensions T and L are safe. So this is the key design procedure. Thank you.